Okay, hello everyone. Today I will show you how we should connect the 5 volt relay to ESP32. Because 5 volt relay needs 5 volt to be driven, but ESP32 has 3.3 volt output from its digital or analog pins, so that causes problem. But I will show you the proper way to connect this relay to ESP32. Okay, so let's start with the very well known way. So I think it's a common problem for everybody. And we have a simple blinking code you can find in the description. It will set 1 and 0 to 26. So let's start with a very well known way. Okay guys, so let's start to draw our circuit 1. It's the commonly mistaken drawing. We will connect the 5 volt relay to ESP32 with the very well known way, and let's draw from 5 volt to directly to VCC port of the 5 volt relay. So let's connect our ground from the ground pin. You can use any of the ground pins of ESP32, and a direct connection to ground port of relay. Now we will connect our trigger port. We choose the discrete output 26 for this sample, so we should connect it directly to V in. It's the trigger port of relay. Let's make it real. Okay, this is our 5 volt pin. Let's connect it to 5 volt output of ESP32 and the other side to VCC pin. As we drew in the drawing video. So let's connect our ground cable. You can connect to any of the ground outputs of the ESP32 because all of them are common. So let's connect it to the ground port of relay. And finally, this is our trigger cable. We choose pin number 26. It's in our sample code. Let's connect 26 to trigger input pin of 5 volt relay. So let's power it up and we will see what will happen. Yes, as you see, there is electric on the relay but no triggering. It doesn't work. And let's try with 3.3 volt output of ESP32, and we will give the 3.3 volt to the relay. It seems it's working, but that's an unstable condition because you can see that the power of LED is very low, and that's not a good thing to drive with the 3.3 volt a 5 volt relay. Let's try with this relay. It's the same brand with same technical specifications. I will show you why this unstable condition. Let's connect the VCC. Everything is same. Same ESP, same code. And let's see. It seems it's working, but no. LED is blinking, but relay is not going to be triggered. No trigger sound, right? So that's really unstable condition. And that's not a correct way. I will show you the proper way by using a logic level converter. Okay, the first, let's draw our proper circuit and then we will make it real. Okay, let's start to draw our new circuit, proper circuit, with a logic level converter. Let's connect our 5 volt from output of ESP32 to input of logic level converter, but the 5 volt side. And the same line, circuit line, to the VCC port of 5 volt relay. So let's connect our ground from the ground pin of ESP32. You can connect one of the ground pins of logic level converter. A proper way is to connect both, but you can connect one. And the ground pin of relay, of course, you should make common all the ground pins of your circuit. and let's connect our 3.3 voltage to logic level converter 3.3. Logic level converter it converts the voltage. If you apply 3.3, you get 5 volt from the other side. Now we will connect to 3.3 side our pin 26. You can connect any of this. We choose the B2, and you should use the opposite part, A2, to trigger port of relay. When we apply from 26 any voltage, 3.3, we will get from A2 5 volt to relay. That's how logic level converter is working. Okay, let's make it real. Okay guys, let's prepare our proper circuit. We are using a breadboard, which will help us. And that's a logic level converter with the 4 pins. You can use any model of it. And this is the 3.3 side. And you can find the 5 volt side. We have 4 pin on the left side and the 4 pin on the right side. This is 5 volt. We connected it. Now let's continue to connect. Okay. Let's find our 5 volt cable and let's connect it to the 5 volt pin of ESP32. Let's connect our ground. And we can use the ground pin of ESP32. And of course we connect all the ground pins in our circuit. And now we should connect 3.3 pin of the logic level converter to 3.3 volt output of the ESP32. It is our power source. And let's connect our trigger port. As you remember, we choose 26. So let's connect it to 26 and we connect from the 3.3 side because our ESP32 gives a 3.3 volt output. So when we applied it from left side, we will get 5 volt from the right side. And so we should connect 5 volt output of logic level converter to the trigger input port of the relay. And let's connect the other pins of relay, and one will be the ground pin. We connected it. And finally, we will connect the 5 volt input of relay, and it's our power source. We are using ESP32 as power source in this example. Now it's okay. So let's power up our ESP32 and let's see that is it working. Yes, and here is the final, and it's working. You can see the trigger sound and you see the power of LED is high and very clear triggering sound. So it's working for any trigger. And you remember the case, the unstable condition for the previous circuit. Now let's try with this circuit. We are using the same relay. We are just changing the cables. We are connecting the other relay to our circuit. Normally you should cut the power. And okay, it's working properly. That's very proper way. You can find some other solutions, but logic level converter is one of the most attractive way to connect 5 volt relay to ESP32. It's very cheap and it's easy to connect. So thank you very much. If you like it, please like this video and share with your friends and subscribe to my channel, and please put your comments in below. Thank you so much.